opening ceremony of the New Zealand International Education Conference 2024. This year is indeed a special one for us, as it has the country of honor at this very prestigious event, which brings together so many experts in the field of international education. This conference provides an excellent opportunity to engage with all stakeholders in a holistic way. India, being the country of honor, is also reflective of the importance attached by the Government of India to enhancing bilateral ties with New Zealand across many sectors, especially the critical sector of education. Dignitaries, friends, education is one sector which has contributed immensely to making India what it is today, the fifth largest economy and a powerhouse in the field of IT, telecommunications, space, research, innovation, startups, etc. Last few years, our two countries have had many high-level exchanges as well as visits by official and business delegations to each other's countries. And these are clearly indicative of the fact that we value our partnership with New Zealand very deeply. A large number of Indian students choose to study here in New Zealand in various schools, colleges and tertiary institutions. The number so far is about 8,000 Indian students at various universities and polytechnics pursuing higher education in the fields of science, IT, hospitality, engineering and architecture. Indian students really value the high quality of education here and the very conducive and friendly environment in institutions here in New Zealand. As we have a large Indian diaspora as well, many Indian origin students are pursuing studies at various schools all across New Zealand, from the primary levels, kindergarten to the A levels. There is no doubt, friends, that this sector holds a lot of potential for furthering India-New Zealand collaboration. As you all know, our New Zealand Centre was established at the Indian Institute of Technology in Delhi in February 2000. Both the IIT Delhi, as we call it, and the New Zealand universities are collaborating for research projects in various subjects like waste management, cyber security, medical technology, renewable energy, and climate change. Subjects which are of great relevance in today's world. It is also heartening to see that several universities from New Zealand are collaborating with premier institutes in India, like the Indian Institutes of Management, Indian Institutes of Technology, Amity University, O.P. Jindal University, and various other universities all across India. These provide an opportunity to have student exchanges, develop common curriculums, learn from each other's curriculums, and have, you know, exchange of best practices, which are very valuable, I'm sure, to both our educational institutions. Under India's new education policy, foreign universities can not only set up bases in India, but they can have a lot more things to do with India, such as online classes, exchange programs, dual degrees, and there are a host of possibilities which have opened up in the last few years. These would definitely be very beneficial to students on both sides. From the High Commission of India, I can assure you that we are also very encouraged to see a number of students going to India from New Zealand to pursue courses of yoga, dance, meditation, Hindi, other languages, and so on. I would like to thank all the organizers of Education New Zealand for their kind invitation to India to be the country of honor. And I would like to thank all of you for being here and wish you very fruitful discussions. I hope especially that you will enjoy the event, Indian dances, and Indian cuisine, and many things Indian today. And for the next 2 days. Wish you all the best. Thank you. Jai Hind. Kyoto.